What's goody, Barons?
On today's episode of BCC TV, we'll hear what annoys our Barons.
Check out this month's Bardist.
See a promo for Palms.
And celebrate Black History Month. I'm Kai Murphy.
And I'm Catherine Smith.
And you're watching BCC TV.
What's going on in the news this week, Kai?
Montgomery County has seen a sharp decline in COVID cases after last month's surge. In the 10 days after winter break, MCS recorded over 14,000 cases of COVID-19. In the last 10 days, that number has fallen to just under 1,200.
In neighboring Howard County, Executive Calvin Ball signed an executive order lifting the indoor mask mandate following the decline in Omicron cases. He recommends the use of them while dropping the requirement, warning people to be careful. However, Howard County Public Schools has said masks are still required in schools.
In BCC News, spectators are now being let into athletic events at 25% capacity. Tickets will be made available through GoFan at noon on game days. Season passes will be honored, and there are only 2 tickets available per purchase. Be sure to come out and support your Barons extra hard for everyone else that cannot make it.
Kai, you know what I absolutely hate?
When teachers don't grade my late assignments on time?
Yes, and no, when people just walk in front of your car in the parking lot when you're trying to leave.
Honestly, a complete travesty. Let's see what grinds our Barons' gears.
What's up, Barons?
I'm Sanaya.
And I'm Sam.
And we've been feeling a bit tense.
The end of the semester was very stressful, to say the least.
Sam, do you want to know what one of my favorite stress relievers is?
What is it?
Venting.
Yeah, I think we've got some stuff to get off our chests.
Let's find out what grinds our gears.
I don't like the way the freshmen walk in the halls. They just take up, like, the entire hallway.
You know what? You're so right. Why do they make a barricade across the entire hall and expect people to just not want to get past? Like, I've got places to be. I don't support violence. I will push you out of the way in order to get to where I need to go.
And something else about freshmen. Why do y'all wear gear from, like, Silver Creek and Westland?
Oh my god, it is so vibrant. Like, I don't want to see that.
I don't even have an issue about the colors, but like, you're at BCC now. You gotta ditch it. You're in high school now. We can save some more hazing for another episode, but outside of you freshmen that don't walk slowly, there are some other people who do walk slowly.
The seniors! It's always them! It's snail pace. Oh my god.
You're not walking to the space shuttle or something. This is not a dramatic slow motion walking scene out of a movie.
You're not getting married. You're not a bride walking down the aisle.
People who don't wear their masks, right? Come on, guys.
We've been wearing masks for a long time. You should know how to wear it right by now.
You need to put it on correctly.
It's not hard.
I don't want to see your nose.
I don't.
Not at all.
It's not cute.
Teachers who don't respond to their emails. I'm waiting. I emailed you.
2 days ago. I'm still waiting for a response.
I bet they're leaving us on red.
It's not hard.
They're leaving us on red.
They're leaving us on red. That's really disrespectful. I can't tolerate disrespect. When people talk to me with my headphones on, it's really frustrating.
We're not paying attention to you. We are in our own world.
I'm listening to, like, SZA, you know? Don't talk to me.
We put in headphones so that we can disassociate from reality and not pay attention to whatever you're doing.
Honestly, yes.
Cats. I hate cats. Whoa. BCC TV members, they're walking red flags out here.
All of them. You are a walking red flag. You go around filming people. That's kind of weird.
That's true. I put myself in front of the whole school.
You talk to a camera.
I talk to a camera.
That's
you talk to
weird.
A camera. That's weird.
Why are you as a man talking to a camera?
Wow. That was so informative.
It seems we've had a lot on our minds.
Clearly. The vibe in the studio is so peaceful now.
We should really do this more often.
Back to you, Kai and Catherine.
Thanks, guys.
Our Bardist this month is adding his creativity to the music scene.
Let's pass it to Nora and Teresa to see this week's Bardist.
What's going on, guys? My name is Lanham. I'm in the 10th grade, and I make music. It just felt super good to make music. Like, it was the most fulfilling thing I'd ever really done. to just walk into like my room, sit down for a couple hours, and just walk away with a complete song. It's what I want to do for the rest of my life. I just don't really see anything fulfilling me this way career-wise, whether that means I'm going to play music for the rest of my life as making my own music, or I'm going to sort of work in a studio or produce music for a living or work in the music business. Artists I draw inspiration from mainly are probably Alex G, Wilco, Mac DeMarco's definitely up there, Current Joys is absolutely up there, Slaughter Beach Dog, Dr. Dog is really good, and I've seen a couple of those guys in concert, and it's just really, really inspiring to see what they do. Playing with other people is super important. I'm in a band with, you know, three of my other friends, and they've really, they're all fantastic musicians in their own right, and they've really just kind of pushed me and taught me to do a lot of stuff, that learn a lot of songs and things and play a lot of different styles that I was never really writing or practicing on my own. I just loop whatever I have and I just play on top of it until I find something that I like and build it out song structure wise from there. For this song, you know, I kind of came up with, you know, a nice sort of plucky lead. You know, it's pretty simple, but it does the trick. Advice I'd give anyone trying to get into music, just do it. Just throw as much time into it as you can. And it really just rewards you. Whatever you give to it, it gives you right back. I found that, especially over quarantine and stuff, it was all I did every day for about a year. And I picked up, you know, 4 instruments and can write songs now. If you just sort of put your time into it, it'll hand back tenfold your reward. All right, back to you, Kai and Catherine.
Thanks, guys.
The winter season is in full swing as we round into February.
Let's kick it to Spencer to see how our Barons are doing in sports.
What's up, Barons? I'm Spencer, and I'm your sports anchor this week. Our Barons finished off another hard-fought week as we near the end of the winter sports regular season. Starting us off, boys basketball dubbed over RM last Thursday and wiped Northwood on Monday with junior Logan Davis nailing 4 threes. On Wednesday, our Barons took a close win against Seneca Valley, with senior Alvin Jackson leading with 21 points. Due to weather conditions last Friday, the game against Clarksburg has been rescheduled to tomorrow, 10 a.m. at home. Our Barons will also face Paint Branch next Tuesday at home. Last Thursday, girls basketball took a close win over Richard Montgomery, with Nora Fairbanks Lee leading with 19 points. Our Barons also took another win over Northwood on Monday. On Wednesday, our girls basketball beat Seneca Valley and currently holds a 12-3 record for the regular season. The girls will travel to Clarksburg this Saturday and Paint Branch next Tuesday. Good luck, Barons. Girls swimming took a close win 98-88 against Whitman, but unfortunately can't say the same for boys swimming. Last Saturday, both boys and girls swimming ended their regular season with a tough loss to WJ. Good luck in the playoffs, fellas. Wrestling split their doubleheader last Saturday with a tough loss to Springbrook, but pulled out a strong win against RM. Palms will have counties at Blair this weekend. Good luck, Palms. Just a reminder, spectators are finally back with limited access at 25% capacity. 150 tickets will be on sale at noon on game day and can be bought via GoFan. No tickets will be sold at the game, so go get your tickets and pop out to support your Barons. That's all for sports this week. Back to you, Catherine and Kai.
Thanks, Spencer.
Speaking of sports, our Palms team has a big competition this weekend.
Check out this promo we have for counties this Saturday at Blair.
Thanks, guys, and good luck to our Palms.
Thanks, Kai. Did you know it's Black History Month?
No, I didn't.
Fair enough.
Let's see what our team has for us this week to kick off our Black History Month series.
Lift every voice and sing till earth and heaven ring with the harmony.
Affirmations are emotional support or encouragement. People tell themselves affirmations every day to empower themselves to be the best that they can, even when they're not at their best.
Hi, I'm Kai Murphy.
My name is Alexa Givens.
I'm Ethan Wright.
I'm Mrs. Adamson.
Hi, I'm Gabby Fudd.
Hi, my name is Alan Ash.
Hi, I'm Ella Cooper.
My name is Philip Bediaco.
My name is Alpha Kate. I'm a Black student at BCC.
I'm Mr. Bishop. I'm a proud Black man.
I'm Kayla Ray, a biracial student at BCC.
Hello, I'm Dr. David Mugerwa, proud assistant principal here at BCC.
Being a person of color in a predominantly white environment can leave people feeling ostracized and discouraged. As a Black student myself, I'm aware that my identity and presence make people feel uncomfortable, leaving me to feel like I don't belong. Stereotypes box me in as a person who is aggressive and uneducated. The way I speak and dress are often criticized and mocked, making me feel like I am a joke or I am lesser.
I'm Jose Mejia, I'm Afro-Latino, and I'm proud of my African roots.
My affirmation is Black is strong.
I'm a proud Black man, and your stereotypes don't define me.
Those that are like me are accepted. My skin is not too dark.
My accomplishments are just as valuable and valid as my non-Black counterparts.
My hair is professional, despite what some might think.
I'm Gerard Dominico Carroll. I'm proud of my Blackness and everything that comes with it.
I'm Tazo Terrence, and I'm more than just a Black athlete. And I am a strong Black man.
My Black affirmation is my hair isn't too messy.
I'm not Derek Henderson, I'm a strong Black man from Philly.
I'm stronger than the stuff that I have to go through at the school.
I'm Devon Bowden, I'm Black, and I'm proud of my Black ancestors.
I stand on the shoulders of giants.
And Kamala Harris once said, dream with ambition and lead with conviction.
I'm Emmanuel Bolte, and I'm a future African-American engineer.
And my affirmation would be to tell everyone that they belong here at BCC.
My skin color does not determine my worth.
I am a descendant of kings and queens.
And my Black affirmation is to be dark with dignity.
And my affirmation that I like to tell myself is I'm equal no matter what others might say.
Hey, I'm Tatiana. I'm biracial. I'm Black and white. And I say to myself every morning, I'm strong and I can do it.
My name is Dominic Anderson, and my Black affirmation is don't shoot yourself for someone else's comfort.
Your appearance does not define you, you define yourself.
And my affirmation is I am unapologetically Black.
Be great today, because your words can be life-changing for the others who you come in contact with.
So every day, myself and others like me have to reassure themselves that they are just as capable as the people around us. More than capable, we are strong, beautiful, powerful, and proud.
Thanks, guys.
And that's all for this week.
Barons, check back in next time for more news, updates, and humor.
Keep those standards high.
And keep the broken sinks low.
I'm Kai Murphy.
And I'm Catherine Smith.
And we're signing off.
Hold it
and
hold it. That was so good. Oh my God. Wow.